are we done? Are we clear with all this, all these three? Origination, processing, underwriting, all the steps are different from each other, right? There is nothing. The only thing, before sending the file, they have a purpose need to fulfill. They are fulfilling that purpose, then they are only moving the file. So underwriting is done, origination, processing. Now the closing. How the closing happens? See, as soon as the file is done in the underwriting, remember the initial 1003 which borrower had filed. He might have given us loan amount at the initial 1003 which signed by the borrower. Loan amount was 100,000. Loan is 100,000, right? In the initial 1003, it's a very important topic, more than important than underwriting, okay? If we are going to lose this segment, we won't be able to very much confident in all these parts. It's a more important than all these three parts because it's the conclusion, right? So if we do not know how it need to be concluded, we won't be able to, you know, start. So loan, initial 1003, right? Loan amount received or applied by borrower, that was 100,000. Very good. Now maybe income they disclosed was $10,000. And then the asset disclosed as maybe $50,000 they have in their bank account. And then they may have told us the property value is $150,000, right? And then file proceeded to processing. When the file came to the processing, they came to know, okay, the asset actually is not 50, but it is only 20,000. So they changed it to 20,000. Now it goes to underwriting and underwriter change the income. Now it is not 10,000, but it is only 6,000. Everything is changing, right? It was the 1003. Now the 1003, all this data is being changed in the different department, right? And even they change the underwriter, change the property value that new appraisal has been received previously when borrowed. Told us the value, okay, it could be 150,000, but it is now only 120,000. So everything is changed, right? Or maybe it is instead of 150, it is 140,000. So all the things, most of the things are changed till underwriting. And when loan was approved, the 1003 had these final values. Obviously, the document which came in, they also prove or they also justify or support all these new information. But the initial 1003 had something different when it came to the final underwriting value. When underwriter evaluated the loan, after evaluating, when they concluded the, or they prepared the new 1003 or the new data, they gave approval on the basis of this data. So it is mostly changed from the initial 1003, right? Now, according to this, all other documents are also going to be changed. So all the documents, initial 1003, now we have updated document, updated 1003, updated 1003, updated 1003, and all other documents are also following them. So what is going to happen? Once loan is ready for the closing, then closing also will be happening in different forms. The number one is, it is the internal team at lender's office, that also known as closing department or closing team, right? So it's happening the closing that we are discussing. Before sending to closing, there is an internal department that we also used to say internal team at lender's office. You can say dog drawing team or closing review team. There are different names, right? Names could be written any and according to the client or according to the lender, right? Or according to the even the team members. So closing team, we can say closing review team. There are different names for these this team. Okay, so internal team. What this internal team is going to do? They are going to draw or they are going to print. Let's say they are going to print all the documents or they are going to print electronically in the PDF form all the document, right, that approval package, whatever the document, they are going to print it, final document. After the approval, final, whatever the loan document has been approved, then they are going to print them with the name of closing package. Now they are going to do the closing package, and that this team, they are going to, it's a, you know, extensive, they have an extensive point of checklist, right? A checklist, there are a lot of, I think 1000 points that need to be checked. So this team will be checking each and everything, whether all the documents are complete, all the documents are accurate, all the documents have the correct information, right? So completeness, accuracy, they are going to check along with the calculations. I mean, there could be some calculations which are not relevant to underwriting. Those will be done, those will be recalculated or calculated by this team, like taxes, insurance, and some other fees, title insurance fee, policy fee, when it will be paid. So like, you know, preparing the final CD, closing disclosure, according to this. So final CD will also be prepared by this team, and all other documents will also be printed out, and there will be a closing package that will be prepared with all the final documents. And that is what we used to say, closing package. That closing package, when we say draw, you know, all the documents will be drawn, means we will be taken out from the system. And then that bunch of document will be sent to third party. Who is third party? Like attorneys. Attorneys. Now, the best part, what I'm going to say, whenever closing happens, the real closing happens, that doesn't happen in the lender's office. But it happens in the either in the county office of the attorneys, or mostly because all the documents like deed, you know, note, all those documents, those need to be recorded in the county office, in the government office, like everywhere or in most of the country, that is how happens, right? First, they will be taking a printout of the bunch, and that bunch will be sent to a closer office. Who are the closer? Again, those attorney, those title company, let's go to, you know, jump into the closer office. Now, here, our internal team, lender internal team processor, they, you know, there will be lot of conditions that will be added by underwriting or even the processing team. Okay, before closing, this document needed, all those documents will be collated, will be collected by this team only. And then what they will be done, yes, closing package is ready, all the new calculations have been done, that work that needed to be done, like taxes, insurance, all the documents are in, then only the package will be finalized, and that package will be withdrawn from the system and will be sent to the attorney's office. Okay, let's go to attorney office. Till now, everything is clear to everyone? Oops, what happened to the origination? Let's make it ORG. Okay. Great. So now let's go to the closing office. What happens? Closer. What do we mean by closer? Closers are mostly going to be the funders as well, like they will be funding closer who are going to close the file. Now, how this file need to be closed? What I happens see. Into the actually closing? Once the loan is approved, what need to be done? The property document. Let's say property, it is a property document. Whenever someone takes a loan, I have a property already existing and I wanted to take a property loan on this property, right? I wanted to take a property loan on this property. I don't want to take new property. So I have this property has the 100,000 of the value. I want to take 50,000 loan on this property, right? But if I took the 50,000 loan from the lender and then I sold the property to someone else, where lender will go? Nobody knows, right? They lender is just, you know, holding that deed or that other document, whatever the agreement they have, and they are just running code to code, right, to get that property. But property belongs to someone else because the ownership has been given to someone else. So what, whenever somebody is going to take a loan, whether it's a purchase or even it's a refinance, they always going to make a new title report. They always need to amend, they always need to modify the title report. Why? Because they need to add the new lender name in this. Even the borrower took the loan 50,000, again after some he again taking the, you know, paying this off, paying off and taking a new loan of 75 or 40,000, let's say, again this title will be modified and then will be again recorded, right? What is happening when record? This is what we are, that is why the file has been received to the closer office. Closer is mostly going to be a real estate certified people, right, person. So they know what to do. So this title report need to be recorded along with DOT, along with note, all those documents need to be recorded here. Where in the county, in the local recording office, like wherever you are living, wherever you are purchasing the property, whatever their local, you know, county office, there they need to record this document. It's a recording, you know, office, we can say recording office. So these closer, what they are going to say, now they received the file from the lender in their office. Who are these closer? These are certified attorneys, trustees that we used to say, like in the India, we have lawyers there. We used to call them attorneys. Very simple. They are well-versed people with the educated people in the, or, you know, certified people in the real estate market or real estate rules and regulations. Great, great. So now what they do, since they are in the real estate business and they are, you know, whenever we are purchasing a property, ownership need to be transferred from one person to, or from seller to the new owner, right? Seller to buyer, right? Seller to buyer, this ownership need to be transferred, right? Initially, this was showing name, maybe it was SK, now it need to show SKK, right? Or maybe those kind of names, like previously it was owned by Sudesh, now it is owned by Indigenous, right? Indigenous Outlook. So that need to be transferred property. Who are the best person to do that? Because, you know, all that transaction, these are the closers. Now, since they are mainly business, in the business, anyone who wanted to do any kind of business, what kind of business they are going to put the name, how they are going to name their business. If any attorney is opening office, attorney who has the certification or who is very, you know, well educated in the real estate market, what kind of name they are going to do? Obviously, because they are in the title business, so they are going to put their name as title, not closer, but title, American title. They can put American title, right? American title or capital title or title capital, whatever. But the name which easily could be recognized that, okay, these are the closer, or these are in the closing business, or these are in the real estate business. They can help us to close our loan, right? Are you guys with me? Are we able to connect whatever we are discussing here?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now that we know who is the closer, how they are going to make their company name. Now that company has a different, you know, whenever they are starting the business, it is not the only that they will be receiving the file and will be doing the closing. They have also, those company are also involved in the different type of task, different type of businesses which are related to real estate, right? Some of them could be broker as well. Some of them, you know, closing, obviously they are going to close the loan. Right, and they can be also funders, and mostly they can be escrow companies as well, right? Now, what are these escrow companies? These escrow companies we will be discussing later, but let's stick to the...
Please put your phone on mute. I could see there are a couple of members who are not on mute. Please put your phone on mute, everyone, okay? So, what happens, they are first closer, or those attorneys are going to approach the lender, and then lender will see how their business is, whether that is authentic and everything, whatever the norms or need to be, you know, however they need to verify, they are going to verify all that information. Then once they are approved, whenever the closing need to be done in that county office, they will definitely be approached in well in advance at the very start of the loan, okay, this loan need to be closed on, or the closing date is going to be this. Now the file has been sent to them, right? What document, what is the first thing they closer are going to do? First of all, they will be going through those documents, and then they are going to call, or lender itself is going to call the borrower to come to the county office or recording office, right? This is what we say closing. So file sent to the closing, to the closer, and now the closing, how closing is going to happen? In the county office, borrower will be coming either to the closer office or directly to the county office, and there borrower is going to sign all the document. The first of all, we saw what is the mortgage. Now who is going to tell me what is mortgage? Or there is an agreement in between lender and borrower. If borrower fails to pay according to the terms and condition, right, then borrower has lender has the right to foreclose the property. That is the purpose of that agreement, that mortgage agreement, that mortgage document, right? Legal, that is a legal document. But according to the terms and conditions, where are the terms and conditions? Terms and conditions are written in the different document, and that is known as note. That is note, that is the document note. In this note document, borrower is going to promise. In this note document, borrower is going to promise that, okay, this is the property address, right? This is the loan amount, principal, loan principal amount, and then this is the interest. This would be my first or my EMI amount. First date of EMI, I will start paying first date of EMI and last date of EMI. So that, like, it's a for 30 years loan, loan principal is 100,000 that borrower, you know, 100,000 that borrower took, interest on maybe 2%, right? EMI amount is going to be like, okay, almost $2,000 per month, and first date is going to be the April, May, June. It could be June 1st, 2021. And the last 30 years loan. 30 years loan, so it's going to be the May 01, 2051. Right? 30 years loan. This is all this information written in the note. And according to this note, borrower is going to sign this document. Right? And it is a promise that these are the terms and conditions, and I will pay the, I will start paying the EMI, and I will end the EMI, or EMI will get ended on this date. All the terms and conditions are written in this note. Okay, it's a promise from the borrower. As soon as borrower is going to sign this document, right? As soon as borrower is going to sign this document, what is going to happen? Borrower will become liable to make the payment. So as soon as borrower is going to sign this document, right, loan could be considered as closed. There could be a date, remote date, it could be the June 12th, April 5, 2021. The date. Now borrower signing the document, so this is the date that we can consider loan closed on April 5. Loan closed on April 5. There was a document that is called initial take of payment. Remember, initial payment. That is the document.